Today we will discuss about the elimination reactions of haloalkanes.
Okay, it is one of the chemical property of haloalkane, elimination reaction. Third chemical property of haloalkane, elimination reaction. Here, monohaloalkanes
are involved in beta elimination reaction. Beta elimination. What is the meaning of beta elimination? The removal of two atoms we called as a elimination. What is the meaning of beta elimination? The removal of two atoms from two adjacent carbon atoms. The removal of two atoms from two adjacent carbon atoms we called as beta elimination. Monohaloalkanes are involved in beta elimination reaction. Okay, here see the one simple reaction. Here I am taking one monohaloalkane CH3CH2Br. This is 1-bromopropane. This is 1-bromopropane. Okay, elimination, remove 1-bromopropane involves in dehydrohalogenation. What is the meaning of dehydrohalogenation? Removal of hydrogen and halogen from the molecule we called as dehydrohalogenation. Okay, dehydrohalogenating agent, reagent, alcoholic potassium hydroxide is used as dehydrohalogenating agent. The dehydrohalogenation of this one bromopropane. Dehydrohalogenation means removal of bromine and hydrogen. Bromine from first carbon atom, hydrogen from second carbon atom in the form of HBr. What happened here? CH3 as it is. This CH2 becomes CH and here it becomes single bond, becomes double bond. 1-propene was formed. What is the reaction? The dehydrohalogenation of 1-bromopropane in the presence of alcoholic potassium hydroxide forms 1-propene. Okay, it is a simple haloalkane. You will get only one product. Okay, here if you take 2-bromobutane. This is the 2-bromobutane. 2-bromobutane. Here, the dehydrohalogenation of this one, the dehydrohalogenation of 2-bromobutane, will get two products. Okay, one product, bromine is common here, hydrogen from this carbon, either this carbon. By the removing of hydrogen from this carbon, we'll get one product. By the removing of hydrogen from this carbon, we'll get another product. Okay, remove the hydrogen from first carbon atom. Okay, here we'll get CH3, CH double bond, CH2, CH3. 1-butene. And okay, if you remove hydrogen from this middle carbon, that means third carbon, we'll get 2-butene. This is 2-butene. Okay, 2-butene is nearly 81% formed and 1-butene is 19% formed. It is a major product, it is a minor product. According to the jet sieves rule, it is also called as set Jeeves rule.
Zaev's rule or Zaev's rule. What is the Zaev's rule or Zaev's rule? Removal of hydrogen from the highly substituted carbon atom. Removal of hydrogen from the highly substituted carbon atom. Okay, during the dehydrohalogenation is called Zaev's rule. See here carbon attached to only one carbon atom. This carbon was attached to two carbon atoms, one and two. So removal of hydrogen from this carbon atom according to the Zaev's rule, or in another way, Zaev's rule or Zaev's rule defined as removal of hydrogen from the carbon which has less number of hydrogen atoms, which has less number of hydrogen atoms, also called as Zaev's rule, during the dehydrohalogenation. During the dehydrohalogenation, removal of hydrogen from the carbon which has less number of hydrogens. Here, two hydrogens are there. Here, three hydrogens are there. Removal of hydrogen from this carbon we called as a Zaev's rule. And two butene is a major product. Two butene was major product. You take one more molecule. Okay, take two bromopentane. This is 2-bromopentane. The dehydrohalogenation of 2-bromopentane will get A and B. Okay, write. What are the AB? You can write. What are AB? And which is major product? Which is major product? You can write. This is the elimination reactions of haloalkanes. Elimination reactions of haloalkanes. Here important one, Zaev's rule or Zaev's rule. Okay, in continuation, we'll see the chemical properties of haloarenes. Haloarenes mainly involves in okay, nucleophilic substitution reaction under high pressure. Nucleophilic substitution reaction under high pressure, and electrophilic substitution reaction, and reaction with metals. Haloarenes mainly involves in, okay, hardly involves in nucleophilic substitution reactions. Okay, easily involves in electrophilic substitution reaction and reaction with metals. Okay, chemical properties of haloarenes. Haloarenes are aryl halides. These are involves in nucleophilic substitution reaction, electrophilic substitution reaction, and reaction with metals. Okay, here first we'll see the nucleophilic substitution reaction. Nucleophilic substitution reaction. Okay, haloarenes hardly involves in nucleophilic substitution reaction. Okay, hardly involves in nucleophilic substitution reaction. These are involves in nucleophilic substitution under drastic conditions only. Okay, what are the reasons for that one? What are the reasons for low reactivity of haloarenes toward the nucleophilic substitution? One is resonance effect. Due to the resonance effect of haloarene. Okay, due to the resonance effect of haloarene. Haloarenes are involved in the resonance. Okay, resonance gives more stability. So, these are hardly involved in resonance effect. Okay, these are hardly involved in nucleophilic substitution reaction. Okay, in haloalkanes, carbon has sp3 hybridization. In haloarenes, okay, here this is the sp3 carbon atom. In haloarenes, okay, here halogen atom attached to the sp2 hybridized carbon. sp2 hybridized carbon halogen, sp3 hybrid carbon halogen. Bond lengths are different. Here bond length is more. sp3 hybrid carbon bond length is more. sp2 hybrid halogen atom bond length is less. Due to the bond length, it doesn't remove easily from the array molecule as a nucleophile. And here one more reason, phenyl carbonium ion. That means nucleophile means halogen atom should be in negative charge and we get the phenyl carbonium ion. Phenyl carbonium was unstable due to the instability of phenyl carbonium ion, due to the very short bond length and due to the resonance effect. Here hardly involves in nucleophilic substitution reactions. Here we'll see the some nucleophilic substitution reaction. Substitution with OH group, OH nucleophile. You take one reaction. Here you take halobenzene. This is a chlorobenzene. When chlorobenzene reacts with sodium hydroxide, okay, 623 Kelvin temperature, 300 atmosphere pressure, and in the presence of H+ ion, chlorobenzene reacts with sodium hydroxide, 623 Kelvin temperature, we should need more and more pressure. 300 atmosphere pressure in presence of acidic catalyst. What happened? Here Na and here Cl replaced with each other. Here Na and Cl reacts with each other and loses NaCl molecule and form the phenol. Cl minus replaced with the OH minus. Negative charged particle replaced with the negative charged particle. Nucleophile is replaced, substituted with the nucleophile. This is the one substitution reaction. If you are introducing the electron withdrawing group. What are the electron withdrawing groups? Electron attracting groups, ring deactivating groups, highly electronegative group. If you are increasing the highly electronegative groups on benzene ring, the reactivity of chlorobenzene increases toward the nucleophilic substitution reaction and the conditions will be decreased. That means here if you are introduce NO2 group is electron withdrawing group. If you introduce NO2 group at any ortho position or any para position, the condition will be changed here. What is the name of this molecule? The name of this molecule is 2-chloro-nitrobenzene. What are the conditions here? Sodium hydroxide as it is. Second one, we don't use the pressure here. Temperature is 443 Kelvin temperature and here no need to use the pressure. Due to the introducing the electron withdrawing group and here H+ ion. Replace, Cl replaces with the OH and removes sodium chloride and form the this molecule. What is the name of this molecule? Orthonitrophenol. What is the name of this molecule? Orthonitrophenol. This is the one second reaction. If you are increasing one more, here you take the chlorobenzene. Already here NO2 group is there. If you increase one more NO2 group, two electron withdrawing groups are there. So the conditions will be decreased. Here sodium hydroxide only. We use sodium hydroxide only and here 368 Kelvin temperature. Just 368 Kelvin temperature. Need not to use H plus ion also. Okay, that means acidic catalyst. At 368 Kelvin temperature, chlorine replaced with the OH minus and form the concerned product. Okay, NO2 here, NO2 here. What is the name of this one? Ortho para dinitrophenol. The name of this molecule, ortho para dinitrophenol. And here, if you increase one more Cl, okay, here NO2, here NO2, and here NO2. Three NO2 groups. Yeah. Okay, I introduced three nitro groups, three electron withdrawing groups. Okay, just it reacts with sodium hydroxide by the warm only. By the warm only. Okay, here chlorine is substituted with OH group. By the warm only, chlorine was substituted. By the warm only, chlorine was substituted and formed the okay trinitro 1, 2, 3 trinitrophenol. Will get the trinitrophenol. Will get the trinitrophenol. Okay, this is about the nucleophilic substitution reaction. Okay, here nucleophilic, these are the hotly involved in nucleophilic substitution reaction due to the three reasons. And okay, just one sample nucleophilic substitution reaction is there. Chlorine is substituted with the OH chloride ion, substituted with the OH minus ion. Okay, by increasing the electron withdrawing groups, the condition will be changed. Okay, chlorobenzene, only chlorobenzene under these conditions form the phenol. And here sometimes pressure was decreased, sometimes temperature was decreased, and finally by the warm only we get the compound. This is about the nucleophilic substitution reactions of haloperines. Next, electrophilic substitution reactions of haloperines. Okay, what are the electrophilic substitution reaction? One electrophile is replaced with the another electrophile. One electrophile is substituted with the another electrophile. Electrophilic substitution reaction. Okay, here haloperines easily involves in electrophilic substitution reactions. Haloperines easily involves in electrophilic substitution reactions.
Like so.
Easily involves in electrophilic substitution reactions. Haloperines easily involves in electrophilic substitution reactions. Okay, here. Okay, these are involved in different electrophilic substitution reaction. One, okay, here one is halogenation and nitration, Friedel Crafts alkylation, Friedel Crafts acylation, and sulfonation. Okay, here these haloperines involves in various types of electrophilic substitution reaction. And here, this is the halo group. This halo group is ortho para directing group. It is an electron donating group, ring activating group, electron donating group, ring activating group. Okay, ortho para directing group. It increases. This group was halo group was increases. Electron donate, electron density increases, electron density at ortho and para position. That's why electrophile attack, next incoming electrophile attack at ortho and para position. Suppose for example, okay, here I am taking one simple halogenation reaction. Halogenation of haloperines. Okay, here I am taking chlorobenzene. Chlorobenzene. This chlorobenzene reacts with chlorine in the presence of ferric chloride or iron and forms two compounds, ortho dichlorobenzene. This is called ortho dichlorobenzene. dichlorobenzene and paradichlorobenzene. Paradichlorobenzene. This paradichlorobenzene is major and this one is minor. This is more stable due to the symmetry. These two chloride chlorine molecules, chlorine atoms are attached in symmetry way. Symmetrical arrangement of two chlorine atoms. This is major and more stable. It is a minor and less stable. Okay, here this is the ortho para directing group. So incoming electrophile attacked at ortho position and para position. Okay, see the mechanism for that simple reaction. Okay, first step, chlorine. First step is okay here, formation of electrophile. Okay, I am writing step wise. Formation of electrophile. Formation of electrophile. Chlorine, here chlorine, in the presence of ferric chloride or iron, both are same. Okay, ferric chloride. Chlorine reacts, here chlorine, ferric chloride is Lewis acid. It accepts the one atom along with the electrons. It accepts the electron rich atom and form FeCl4- and Cl plus. This Cl plus is electrophile. This is the electrophile. Okay, in second step, formation of sigma complex or attacking of electrophile. How electrophile attack on this one? See here chlorine is electron donating group. Here we have the chlorine atom has three electron pair. In three electron pair, one of the electron donated towards benzene ring. Then these electrons are transferred towards next carbon atom. Then the electron density increases at ortho position. Then see the reaction. Here bond. Electron donates from chlorine to ring. Okay, double bond was formed. Here chlorine. Chlorine gets the positive charge. And here we get the negative charge. Negative charge indicates increasing the electron density at ortho position. Then again it involves in these negative charge electrons are transferred towards next carbon atom. Then negative electrons are transferred towards the para position. And here electron transfer here means the double bond formed here. Already here Cl plus. Here negative charge was formed. Here electron density increases at para position. Again it involves in resonance. These electrons are transferred here in continuation. Okay, one more ortho position is there here. Okay, electron density increases third position also. These are the three resonance structures. The mixture of these three resonance structures, 1, 2, 3. The mixture of these three resonance structures we called as a sigma complex. Take any one resonance structure from these three. Okay, first I am taking for our convenient. Okay, I am taking only first resonance structure. Okay, and final step, I am writing final step here. Third step, formation of stable complex or removal of H plus ion. Okay, you take any resonance structure, one double bond, Cl plus, here bond. This is the one resonance structure. Okay, this was reacts with FeCl4-. Okay, here hydrogen is there. Okay, here FeCl4- attacks at hydrogen. Okay, here it reacts with the Cl plus. Okay, in the presence of FeCl4-, in the presence of Cl, FeCl4-, And what happened here? Double bond Cl plus here Cl. Okay, and here hydrogen is there. Bond. Okay, in the presence of again FeCl4 minus. Okay, this hydrogen donate toward the carbon. These electrons are transferred toward the chlorine. And hydrogen and FeCl here in FeCl4 minus Cl minus is there. That Cl minus reacts with the H, this H, and form the HCl. FeCl4 becomes FeCl3. And here electron transferred here will get bond here and chlorine here. And already bond is there. Already here bond is there. And here it is a gold chlorine. And we get the ortho. Ortho dichloro benzene. If you take this second resonance structure, we will get the para dichloro benzene. We will get the para dichloro benzene. That means ortho dichloro benzene, para dichloro benzene. Okay, this is the one of the electrophilic substitution reaction. Okay, along with the mechanism. Then in continuation, we'll see the some more electrophilic substitution reactions of haloarenes. That is, okay, nitration. Chlorobenzene reacts with the nitration mixture, forms ortho chloro nitrobenzene and para chloro nitrobenzene. Okay, second one, nitration. Nitration, okay, take halobenzene, reacts with nitration mixture, concentrate sulfuric acid, 2 moles of concentrate sulfuric acid, 1 mole of concentrate nitric acid at 60 degree centigrade temperature. Okay, here it produces NO2 plus electrophile. NO2 plus attacks at ortho position and para position and forms, okay, this molecule are orthochloronitrobenzene. This is a minor product. Okay, para chloro nitrobenzene, it is a major product due to the symmetry moment. Okay, third one, Friedel-Crafts alkylation. Okay, Friedel-Crafts alkylation. Chlorobenzene reacts with alkyl halide. Methyl chloride, I am taking methyl chloride. Okay, it reacts in presence of anhydrous aluminium trichloride. Should use anhydrous aluminium trichloride. If you use hydrous aluminium trichloride, okay, Friedel-Crafts alkylation reaction doesn't take place. That water molecule, okay, hydrous molecule or water molecule reacts with methyl chloride and form the methyl alcohol. Okay, due to the formation of methyl alcohol, there is no Friedel-Crafts alkylation, there is no formation of the concerned product. Okay, here it produces methyl electrophile. This methyl electrophile adapted ortho position and para position and form, okay, here orthochlorotoluene. This is called orthochlorotoluene. And finally, we'll get one more, parachlorotoluene. Orthochlorotoluene and parachlorotoluene. And one more reaction, Friedel-Crafts acylation. Okay, you take chlorobenzene or bromobenzene or any, reacts with acetyl chloride, CH3C double bond OCl. We called acetyl chloride. This is reacts with anhydrous aluminium trichloride. Same, anhydrous aluminium trichloride forms orthochloroacylbenzene. This is orthochloroacetylbenzene or acylbenzene. Okay, one more product. Okay, parachloroacetylbenzene. Parachloroacetylbenzene or orthochloroacetylbenzene. Okay, parachloroacetylbenzene and orthochloroacetylbenzene was formed. Same, parachloroacetylbenzene is major, okay, due to the symmetry.
One more electrophilic substitution reaction is there, that is sulfonation. We'll see in continuation sulfonation. What is the sulfonation? Okay, introducing of SO3H group, sulfonyl group, we called as sulfonation. Introduction of SO3H group, we called as sulfonation. See, sulfonation. Chlorobenzene reacts with 2 moles of concentrated sulfuric acid at 50 degree centigrade temperature. What happens? It releases SO3H neutral electrophile. This neutral electrophile is at ortho position and para position. Okay, here we'll get 2 compounds. Here SO3H and here SO3H. This is called orthochlorobenzene sulfonic acid. This is called parachlorobenzene sulfonic acid. Orthochlorobenzene sulfonic acid and parachlorobenzene sulfonic acid. This is the parachlorobenzene sulfonic acid. Okay, major and other one is minor. Okay, and reaction with metals. Okay, here Wurzburg reaction and Wurzburg reaction. And here Ullmann reaction. 3 reactions are there. Okay, those are easily involved in the reaction. Okay, here first halobenzene reacts with the magnesium, chlorobenzene reacts with the magnesium and form phenyl magnesium chloride. This is called Grignard reagent. Phenyl magnesium chloride, we called as Grignard reagent. And Wurzburg reaction. What is the Wurzburg reaction? 2 moles of alkyl halide reacts with the sodium metal and form the concerned alkanes, higher alkanes. Here, Wurzburg reaction means when halobenzene reacts with sodium metal and methyl chloride. Chlorobenzene, methyl chloride reacts with sodium metal in presence of dry ether. Forms, which compound is formed here? 2 moles of sodium chloride was removed and form toluene. Benzene with CH3 group, we called as toluene. This reaction is called Wurzburg reaction. And Wittig reaction. What is the Wittig reaction? Wittig reaction means take 2 moles of chlorobenzene and reacts with sodium metal. 2 moles of chlorobenzene reacts. Wittig reaction. 2 moles of chlorobenzene. 2 moles of chlorobenzene reacts with 2 moles of sodium in presence of diether. What happened? 2 moles of chlorine and 2 moles of sodium uses 2 moles of sodium chloride and form this molecule. Benzene with one more benzene. Phenyl and phenyl we called as biphenyl. This is called Wittig reaction. And one more last reaction, Ullmann reaction. Okay, 2 moles of chlorobenzene. Here one chlorobenzene reacts with 2 moles of copper. Metal was changed, copper. Here, one more, chlorobenzene. Same reaction, in the presence of dry ether, it loses 2 moles of cuprous chloride, like this, and forms same compound, that is biphenyl. If you use copper instead of sodium, we call it as Ullmann reaction. Okay, this is about the chemical properties of haloarenes and haloalkanes. And one more topic is there, polyhalogen compound. Okay, in continuation, we'll see the topic in next class, the next video. Thank you.